Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial. My name is Thilo. This tutorial shows how to control MADRIX 5 remotely via DMX input. Please note, in MADRIX 5 you can use the MADRIX USB 1, the MADRIX Stellar, the MADRIX Plexus and the MADRIX Luna range as USB to DMX input interfaces. In this tutorial, a MADRIX USB 1 is connected to the PC. The USB 1 is one of the smallest USB to DMX interfaces for output or input, which can control up to 512 DMX channels, one DMX universe. The MADRIX USB 1 comes with a 5-pin XLR port. If it should be used as DMX in interface, a XLR 5-pin male-to-male adapter is required. In our task, we have to configure the connected MADRIX USB 1 as input interface. To control MADRIX remotely with a DMX controller, the pre-configured essential remote protocol should be enabled with the start channel 1. Now let's have a look to MADRIX. To set up the DMX input configuration, we open the Device Manager via Preferences, Device Manager. We will find the USB 1 in the DMX devices list. By default, it is enabled as output interface and we have to change the communication direction to input. Therefore, we select the USB 1 and click the input checkbox in the settings section and apply. In the next step, we have to configure the DMX input and the remote protocol. Therefore, we activate the DMX input tab. In the DMX input tab, we select the first DMX universe. By the way, the DMX input universes are virtual universes. It is also possible to use another input universe or to work with more than one input interfaces. But in case of the usage of only one DMX input device, I recommend to work with the first input universe. Now we assign the DMX in device. With a click at the arrow in the device section, the list of all input devices opens and we choose the connected USB 1. If a DMX controller is connected to the USB 1 and we open the DMX monitor with a click at the monitor button, we can see the incoming DMX data. When we move the first fader, we can see the input of the first DMX channel. If we move the second one, we see the input value of the second DMX channel, the third one for the third DMX channel, the fifth one for the fifth DMX channel, and so on. In the last step, we have to enable the remote control and activate the essential protocol. Therefore, we select the remote checkbox on the top right side. The remote control section is now activated and we can choose the desired remote protocol or we can create a user-specific one. In our tutorial, we will use the essential protocol. The DMX chart of the essential protocol you will find in the manual in the chapter Input, Interoperability and Remote Control. The essential protocol requires 6 DMX channels to control 6 functions remotely in MADRIX. Channel 1 will control the master, channel 2 the storage ID deck A, channel 3 the place ID with fade deck A, channel 4 the fade time, channel 5 the fade type and channel 6 the speedmaster of deck A. In this tutorial, we will control MADRIX remotely from DMX start channel 1. So, we don't need to change the DMX start address. If it is required to control MADRIX remotely beginning from another DMX channel, simply change the DMX start address here. Now we can close the device manager and we can control MADRIX remotely. When we change the value of the first fader, the master will be changed, the third fader will change the storage places, and for instance the sixth fader will change the speed between minus 10 and plus 10 by default. That's it for now. Thank you for watching.